Welcome to the video. Last week I ended up getting LASIK surgery, and in this video I want to talk to you about the following days after the surgery, after the procedure, how it went for me, how I felt, and also anything I would have changed, done differently. We're going to be covering all that in this video. Before we get started, I invite you to subscribe. We always post new videos about getting better, personal development, personal finance, fitness, just about every topic when it comes to becoming the best versions of ourselves. So go ahead and smash that subscribe button. Also give us a like. It really helps out the channel and it helps out this video. So let's get started. I did not expect the procedure to go the way it went. It was just totally not what I expected. I thought it was gonna be a lot worse, and you know, off the bat, it was pretty easy, pretty straightforward.
Oh man.
He's here, oh my goodness.
It's done.
Got the Gucci glasses. If you're nervous or you're anxious before it, don't be. The process is pretty easy, it's so fast. And quick, and then as soon as you're done, you can already start seeing. So that shit fucking felt amazing, because that's like the first time in my life that I was able to see clearly without glasses or contacts.
When we got there, they did not allow us to take in our camera to keep recording, and the reason why is because everything with the pandemic right now, they have like limited capacity and they can't allow too many visitors to enter the lobby area. The very first thing is they give you a Xanax so you can relax. So that Xanax starts to kick in and you just feel like really relaxed and you're ready for the surgery. And I'm not gonna lie guys, like I was pretty nervous. I was nervous as hell, because when it comes to surgeries or like eyes, especially eye surgeries, like I'm a chicken for that kind of stuff, man. My eyes have always been very delicate, so I was kind of nervous at the beginning. But then we ended up getting into the office and the doctor came in. He sat next to me and he started talking to me about the procedure, and he just explained what to expect, how the process is gonna go. They lay you down and they put a machine over your eyes, and what that machine does is that it removes like the corneal flap that's on your eye, so they can laser beam into the cornea. And that's like one of the strangest parts, because when they're removing the cornea, you can actually smell the burning of the cornea when they start applying the laser to it. So I thought that part was pretty weird. It didn't hurt, but you know, you can smell it during that process, you can hear it. And then after that, it feels like the eye doctor is like painting some stuff on your eyes. It's a very strange feeling. And then just like that, it's done. And then they go on to the next eye, they do the same process, they put the laser on you. They tell you to look at a green laser while they're doing the process. And while they remove the cornea flap, like your eye just goes completely blank. Like you can't see anything. You just, you know, your vision is gone. But then suddenly it comes back. As soon as they're done, you can actually already start seeing. You have 20/20 vision. It's a little blurry, but you can see. Then you get out of the procedure and they just kind of give you the last breakdown of what to expect, what to experience. And then that's it. They give you your medicine and then you're off. Right after that, Genesis picked me up. We came back home and we rested, we relaxed. And I just knocked out as soon as I got home. Got a big sandwich with Chick-fil-A, devoured it, and then I knocked out. I would say that the hour right after the surgery, your eyes do sting a bit and they get irritated. They're pretty sensitive to light. You can't have them open. They give you a pair of sunglasses and they make you wear them all the way until you get home, right before your nap. So once you knock out, you take your nap, and you wake up, like you already feel like your eyes are pretty beat up. I just woke up from a nap. It's been like 9 hours from the surgery, but I feel a lot better now. And my eyes are pretty beat up. I've noticed that there's like red bruises around my eyes, like little red marks, but the doctor told me that was gonna be like, you know, normal, and that was gonna be part of the procedure, just let it heal, let you know, the recovery do its thing. The medicine that they give you during the procedure is, they give you three types of medicines. One is an anti-inflammatory, the other one's an antibiotic, and the third one is a Xanax. The Xanax is the one that you get right before the procedure, and then they also give you this one. You know, I'm probably gonna chop this up, but it's moxifloxacin solution. I know I fucked that all up. And the next thing is prednisolone acetate. So they also give you that one. They give you both of these, and you have to take these drops immediately after the surgery. For the first 7 days, you have to take it around 3 to 4 times a day. They also give you some Bling Tears lubricating eye drops, and these are, you can use these eye drops for, like, they're just meant to keep your eyes lubricated. They recommend for you to take them every 15 minutes on the day of the surgery right after. So every 15 minutes, you gotta keep applying them, keep applying them. The effects right after the surgery was like bruises on my eyes. Hope you can see them there. They're like, you get like red marks on your eyes. So the way the doctor explained it is because when you're doing the procedure, they put like a apparatus that sucks the eye out so that you can do the removal of the flap on the eye. And during that process, it tears certain blood vessels on your eyes, and that's just part of the procedure. It's expected to happen. It's just gonna take some time to recover and to heal, but that's usually why it happens. That's one thing that I noticed, and then the other thing that I noticed is that the eyes get very dry, so using your lubricating drops is gonna help out a lot. You gotta lube it up as much as possible, and that will help out a lot. It's gonna help you feel better. It does feel very strange that you do not have to use contacts anymore and glasses. Like, I would catch myself at the end of the night wanting to take off my contacts. You know, I'm so used to having them, and now it's like you don't have to do that anymore. Just finished doing the post-op, and the doctor, you know, they said everything looked good, gave me the green light to start training again. They said to take it easy when it came to grappling and sparring. I have a jiu-jitsu tournament coming up on Saturday, and I'm trying my best to get ready and heal up before the tournament. I might not have the same preparation and training that I did in the first tournament. And I feel like I have a good foundation of jiu-jitsu that I can defend myself. So I'm just gonna go ahead and jump in there, hopefully get that first place again and knock it out. They recommend not to spar or grapple in at least 1 to 2 weeks. And to just take it easy, don't do anything that's gonna exert your eyes too much. Another cool thing about LASIK Plus is that they offer a lifetime warranty. So at any point, if you ever need to get LASIK surgery done again, you can do it with LASIK Plus. And this is typical sometimes with LASIK surgery, especially if you have like a lot of astigmatism or you have a lot of eye issues. Doctor was explaining to me that usually happens around 5 to 10 years. So it's not something that's gonna happen so soon, but it is something to be expected. And that's what makes it great with LASIK Plus, that if you ever get to the point that you need to get the surgery again, it's already covered off the initial payment that you did at the beginning when you decided to get the surgery. So it's all included and you don't have to worry about it in the long run. You can just do the procedure again and you're covered. The last thing that I want to mention is that the initial reason why I wanted to get LASIK surgery was so I can spar harder in training, and I can grapple and not worry about my contacts falling off or my vision getting distorted. And after doing the entire procedure, I also came to the conclusion that there's also another surgery called PRK. And after doing some more research on that surgery, PRK, for fighters, it might be better to get PRK if you're a professional fighter, if you're a professional boxer, someone that's used to, you know, combat sports, you're used to getting hitting back, it might be better to do PRK. It's a surgery that can endure more of that damage when it comes to combat sports or any sport like that in general, any contact sport. PRK is like the same cost roughly to what LASIK is. It takes longer to recover from the surgery, at least like 4 to 5 days. So the doctor was explaining to me that PRK was longer and they would recommend to do LASIK instead. So I ended up, you know, opting for LASIK surgery, and I'm glad I did because it was pretty fast. You know, I recovered pretty quickly, and you know, the entire procedure is pretty easy. So I'm glad I did the LASIK instead of the PRK. I would also invite you to look into PRK. It seems like that's a better alternative for LASIK, especially if you're in more of those situations where you're constantly grappling or you're fighting, you're in a combat sport, or you're just in some type of professional of that sort. PRK might be a better alternative for you. Overall, I'm happy with LASIK and I'm excited to see how my vision is gonna develop over time.
If you made it this far into the video, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up, and also invite you to subscribe to the channel. We drop new videos every single week and you don't wanna miss them. I will catch all of you in the next video. Stay strong and keep on conquering. Let's go.